Welcome to Engineering Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will briefly talk about the basics of SymPy. More applications of SymPy in algebra, calculus, statistics, and complex numbers will be discussed in the next two videos. SymPy is a Python library for symbolic mathematics. It is an alternative to Mathematica. SymPy started as a Google Summer of Code project. It gradually matured from a toy into a powerful tool. Its core capabilities include basic arithmetic, simplification, expansion, functions, substitution, etc. Its application has been spread into many fields like polynomials, calculus, solving equations, discrete math, matrices, geometry, physics, and statistics. This is a recommended way of importing SymPy library into our own programs. From SymPy, import everything. The rational class in the SymPy library represents a rational number as a pair of two integers, the numerator and the denominator. In this example, we create a variable a, which is a rational number. The numerator is 1 and the denominator is 3. That means a is 1/3. We can then do arithmetic operations like this multiplication using a. This result is 2/3. The data type of a is a SymPy rational. The benefit of representing them with symbols is that they can be evaluated with arbitrary precision. This is very different from a float number. If we define a variable b, which is a float number, 1/3, it will be represented in the memory by its approximation, 0.333. Because this is a float number, its value is cut off after a certain number of digits behind the decimal points. So all the following arithmetic operations will also be an approximation. SymPy has defined some special constants for us to use. This is convenient if we need to use an accurate representation of these constants in our own programs. All these constants are case sensitive. The first one is a constant, pi. We can use it directly. For example, this means pi squared. The output is pi to the power of 2. This output is not very intuitive. There is a secret switch in NumPy. We can use the initial printing function and set the pretty print to true. What it does is to change its printing mode to pretty printing. After that, let's try it again. This time, the output is pi squared, which is in the form we commonly see in textbooks. This pretty printing is more intuitive, but of course, if you want to revert back to the original printing mode, you can change this true to false. The eval f function of pi with an argument 20 will show the first 20 digits of pi. This is the output. It has a total of 20 digits. This capital letter N is a SymPy function that will also evaluate the symbol to get the float approximation. By default, it will show the first 15 digits. If we specify the second parameter, for example 7, then it will show only 7 digits. The capital letter E is another constant, Euler's number. These are the first 20 digits of E. The first 15 digits of pi plus E are shown here. Two lowercase letters, OO, are a very special constant. It means infinity. We know that infinity is greater than any number, no matter how large the number is. So the result of this comparison is true. Infinity plus any number is still infinity. So the output here is still infinity. There are two ways of creating symbolic variables. We can define them individually using the capital symbol function. It's singular. The argument is a string x. Now x will just represent this symbol x. Similarly, y just represents this symbol y. We can also define them together using this lowercase symbols function. It's plural. The argument is a string of two letters, x and y, separated by a space. They can also be separated by a comma. The left-hand side has two variables, x and y. X will represent x and y will represent y. After we define these symbolic variables, we can use them for math operations. For example, x plus y plus x minus y. Plus y and minus y will be cancelled. So the only thing left is 2x. X plus y squared will just produce this result. X plus y squared. In these examples, we use x to represent x and y to represent y, just for convenience. But this is not mandatory. You can use x to represent y and use y to represent x, just like this statement. So if we print x, the result is y. If we print y squared, the result is x squared. Symbolic variables can also represent symbols with multiple characters. In this example, x represents variable 1 and y represents variable 2. So if we print x, the result is variable 1. If we print y squared, the result is variable 2 squared. For the following examples, we still use x to represent x and y to represent y. This statement will expand x plus y cubed. The output is the expanded form. We can expand cosine x plus y. We set the trigonometric transform to be true. This is the expanded form. We can simplify this division expression. The numerator is x plus x times y. The denominator is x. After simplification, the result is just y plus 1. The sum function will calculate the sum of a series of items that can be expanded using the same formula like this one. The numerator is just 1 and the denominator is x squared plus 2 times x, where x is an integer index. It goes from 1 to 10. See the output. This is a very beautiful math representation of what I just described. This is the formula we just used to calculate the sum. We have a big sigma to represent the sum. The index x is from 1 to 10. If we want to do the calculation and get the final results, we can just use this doIt method. After evaluation, the result is the rational number 175 over 264. We can also calculate the product of a series of items that can be expressed using this formula. The only difference is that the function name is changed to product from sum. In this output, we see this big pie, which represents the product. After we evaluate this expression using the doIt function, this is the result. The denominator is a very large number. Okay, that was a brief introduction to SymPy. More discussions can be found in the next two videos. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.